Welcome back. Boom. Happy Saturday. Spent the day, the first half of the day, putting bunk beds together and things like that. So that's fun. Anyway, so we're going to do the boat, the big gas boat. We're not going to do a maiden today because it's windier than hell and raining. So, but what we're going to do is we're going to modify our electric starter, which we have to do. And we're going to fire it up, and I'll probably have to use the hat cam for that because it ain't going to fit under here. So, you know your boat is cool when you have a starter like this. How cool is that? This is what starts the fucking boat, right? I got a belt. It's in the house, like a timing belt. The belt goes around the pulley, high speed, low torque, and then this rung here is going to be for your high torque, obviously. Yeah, fucking cool, man. It's awesome. So, it looks like a moped starter. Like they took this off Bardwell's Main Transportation, right? So anyway, it came with this great instruction that, you know, is ripped off. This is a very professional thing here. Starter will get burn with wrong battery or wrong battery connector with wrong polarity. Starter power wire male connector, which last time I checked looked like that. Let's see. Male is positive. Blah, blah, blah. So the starter will work with gas engines from 23 to 30 cc. We're running a 26. Do not use on nitro. I'm not really sure why it says that. Like, it's going to spin it too fast. Because we're going to use it on a nitro eventually, but oh well. Do not run starter at high speed without load, blah, blah, blah. Okay, so what we're going to do first is we're going to measure just to make sure our Chinese friends have this correct. Uh-oh, maybe. Got a bad battery and meter. Shit, let me go fix this. Now, I don't know if this is 9-volt or not. I'll check. Well, it's a 9-volt, and it does not matter because I don't have any. So we're just gonna take their word for it. So we're gonna put an XT60 on here. Yep. So battery goes right here. So we're gonna call this male. And I hope Bardwell is watching this so he can understand the difference. Oh, Bardwell. Oh, shit. Okay. So, that's going to be our ground. Okay. I'll tie it around there so I don't mess it up. Then, the biggest thing with XT60s is people don't have a hot enough soldering iron when they do them, okay? So what we're going to do, let's do this. Get your soldering iron fucking cheerleader hot, man. I mean, like, boom, smoking hot. Where is my solder? Ah, there it is. Okay. All right. We should be good and warm. Oh, fucker. We'll just do it the hard way. And yes, I do have helping hands. No, I'm not using them. Okay. Let that smolder a bit. Okay. And we're going to grab an XT60. Quad side, of course. And then we're just going to do it like this. Press it in. It's going to get really hot. It's okay. It's only fingers, right? Bam, just like that. Okay. Ground side. Same principle. But that is the biggest thing. You know, I've had a lot of people send me, new guys usually, send me messages about soldering XT60s. And I think a long time ago, I actually even did a video on how to do battery connectors and things like that, because it's a pain in the ass. But the reason it's a pain in the ass is because your soldering iron isn't hot enough. So, And, you know, you might want to use a helping hands for this. It gets exceptionally hot. Whoops, like that. So, somebody asked me in the video yesterday, I think it was, whatever day that was, he said, "Dude, what the fuck is up with all your needle nose pliers?" Because they all have, except for this pair I'm using right now, they all have paint on them. And that's because I use them for hydro dipping. I need to soak them all in acetone. All right. Bada bang. Are you kidding me right now? Yeah, there is such a thing as too hot, by the way. I took it off before it... Yeah, that's way too fucking hot. That's all right. It's melting the connector, actually. Yep. Woohoo. It's all right. We'll bend it back. There we go. Damn. Hoo-ah. Yeah, that was way too hot. But anyhow, I'm going to see if I can dig up a 9-volt battery, and I want to test this just to make sure we're not going to smoke it. But I'm pretty sure it's right. So what you should be able to do is put your meter on continuity and then ground side to chassis should get continuity. So bam, let me go see if I can find a battery. All right, I actually found one, rock and roll. So we're going to put the meter on. Continuity, bam, like that, and we're just going to make sure ground is ground, and everybody's copacetic. Okay, rock and roll. So, I'm going to go ahead and put some heat shrink over this.
We'll be right back.
All right, and we're done. So, bam, there she is. Now, this is a 3S. This particular model only runs off of 3S. I don't know. It might run off of 2S. I don't know. But it says do not run anything above 3S. So, it's got this. This is a 2200 ADC. Should be good enough. Goes right there. Put our balance plug in here. Hey, this is cool. Fucking now Bardwell can't do nothing with his moped. There we go. Here, let's do this. Let's put a little magic marker on here. Got some kick. All right. I imagine it's pretty strong. So, here's the belt that came with it. I don't know why they give you toothed belts, because pulleys on motors are not toothed. I'm not sure. But anyway, it goes under here. That locks it in there a little bit. And bam, there you go. Nothing but a peanut. Nice and easy. So, yeah, we're going to go ahead and charge this battery up. And I'm probably going to have to switch over to the hat cam. And we're going to fire that fucking boat up. And actually, it looks like it's clearing up out, but... probably too late in the day to really go down the river and get a run. So maybe tomorrow, that's my goal. But there's a couple of little things that I want to do with the boat anyway, mod-wise. So anyway, bam.
All right, kids. Hopefully this is working and you can see shit, because I'm not used to using JJ's cheap-ass hat cam up close for stuff. So first thing we got to do, let's see. Yeah, this retaining clip doesn't look like there's any... Huh. Yeah, that's not reached not very far, is it? That's okay. We won't worry about this go around. So, first thing we need to do is got to remember most boats, single prop boats, are counterclockwise if you're facing them, just like an airplane, right? So, we got to figure out which way this is going. Ah, you're charged. Good enough. All right. So, we're going to put in the bot tree. I already know which way it goes, but we're going to prove it. Okay. Wire this up. Okay. And it's going to spin this way. Okay. So that means we need to go that way onto the boat. Easy enough. Now, I have never started this boat ever. Never heard it run. but we're about to. Rota Twister. All right. Oh, I'm going to bring that with me. Okay. So, garage is a mess right now because we got bunk beds we put in. So, there's all that shit. So, canopy's already loose. There we go. Here's our pulley. All right. So, we're going to go this way onto it. And hopefully everything rock and roll. So now we need, a radio. And turn this on. Electric boat. Model 2. I haven't named it yet, but that is what it is. Okay. Now, trying to keep my head low so you guys can hopefully see this. I have not charged up the radio battery, but I'm sure it's fine. Just leave it like that. Okay. My buddy Nay down in Arizona gave me this camera for the boat. It's really cool. Well, he didn't give it to me for the boat, but that's what we're using it for. So, let's turn it on. Make sure everybody's copacetic. All right, this is a chokeless carb. There is no choke on it. So one thing you can do to start these things, you can put your hand over the carb and pull it up. You know, just choke it out with your hand, boom, fire it up. We are just gonna prime it and fire it up. And we're gonna see what the fuck happens. Okay. Wish me luck. See what happens. Hopefully you guys can see this. Well, I don't care who you are, that is fucking cool. Oh man, I'm in love. That seems like the idle's a little high for my taste. We're gonna bring the idle down before we run it, just because this thing, we took the clutch off, so it's going to be in forward motion no matter what. Maybe I'll test it in the water, we'll see what happens. So. All right, that spun off. We're gonna Loctite that baby on there. Excellent, 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 excellent. I love it. So, we will do that, but aside from that, she looks fucking cool. Runs, hot. Don't wanna get her too warm, it's a liquid cooled motor. So kids, hopefully tomorrow, I'm gonna get some water time with this guy and we will see what we can do. So until then, keep the dry side up. Later. Bye.